The prices of prime residential spaces in Manila grew the most during the last quarter of 2023. According to the Prime Global Cities Index by real estate consultancy firm Knight Frank, the luxury housing market in the Philippine capital grew by 26.3% year on year. The firm says this increase is driven by rising housing demand, with agents reporting a surge among expatriates returning to manage local businesses. Now, coming in at second is Dubai with a 15% growth, followed by Mumbai in India. The Metro Manila Development Authority is set to launch an information drive about the ban on e-vehicles plying Metro Manila roads. The ban implemented to reduce accidents involving e-bikes and e-trikes took effect Monday. But President Marcos called for a one-month deferment of the crackdown on such vehicles to allow the public to become more familiar with the new rule. In response, the MMDA says it will use the pause to educate the public.
Sasamantalahin namin itong pagkakataon na ito na ipaalam sa kanila na seryoso yung ating pamahalaan na i-regulate itong ganitong klase sa sasakyan sa mga pangunahing lansangan. At ganoon din po, inform sila noong penalty kung sakali sila ipasusuway. At opportunity rin. Kasi pag wala na magiging excuse after this 1 month, siguro enough na yan para inform sila to sabihin sa kanila kung saan yung alternatibong ruta. At rin mapaghandaan nila, magpapa-meeting po kami ng mga traffic heads to identify yung mga alternatibong ruta. At makasama po yan sa information campaign.
A Philippine Environment Group urges a probe on the alleged illegal quarrying in a protected area in Quezon Province. The group Tanggol Kalikasan said Friday it was concerned over reports of such activities on the slopes of Mount Banahaw in Siariaya Town. The group said aside from its environmental impact, some locals in the area have also complained of the quarrying. It also said it would meet with local officials next week for their concern.
Yung ating pong nasaksihan ano, na nasa loob ng buffer zone, ng protected area ng Banahaw po, yung activity na noong mismong ano po, ng mga, actually ito mga legal, may permit eh, ano, may mga permit sila, pero mukhang lumalabas na sila. Kailangan itong imbestigahan, ano, inaukulan, ano, mula sa lokal na pamahalaan hanggang doon sa protected area superintendent at protected area management board. At ganun din po yung nag-issue ng permit, yung Provincial Mining and Regulatory Board. Kasi sila po ang may responsibilidad yan.
The Luzon and Visayas power grids again placed on alert status on Friday amid thin reserves. The national grid operator said the Luzon grid will be on red alert from 3 to 4 this afternoon and again from 6 to 10 p.m. due to unexpected surge in demand. It said 19 power plants remain on forced outage while 3 are running on low power capacities. As for the Visayas grid, it is on red alert from 1 p.m. until 8 tonight and on yellow alert until 9 p.m. The red warning means power supply cannot meet consumer demand. The Luzon and Visayas power grids have been operating under alert this week as intense heat pushes power demand higher.